Is it me you're looking for? Everybody knew it. It's always me that we're looking for. Yeah, it's a brother, it's a sister, it's a friend. Because I'm nice and kind and I respect. And Cock, I did respect too. You're ugly and shit, but whatever. His achichincle, which wasn't achichincle, the guy he called in to. Maybe then he said, go get me a beer. But then he did not drink. So he asked him to do something else. This young man, guy, his name is Dominguez. I know it's his last name, but that's how he was called, Dominguez. Dominguez trusted Coca. He did something, should I say? Okay. I did not initiate this video with that idea alone. I had another one. Oh, Coca's mother didn't live in La Doctora's anymore. He grew up there, but she did not live there. I don't know where she lived. I know it in the map, I haven't. Like more to the east side, east, southeast. But I don't know the name. Gina Batista. No, she was on TV and she was like news reporter or news sprecher. She moved to Cuernavaca. She did not have friends. I was her only friend. Because no one wants to be friend with a journalist. Because everything you say is going to be taken, could be taken against you. Todo lo que dices puede estar usando, puede usarse en tu contra, right? Yeah. Because she was gossipy. And she was malevolent. Because the news was all about bad news. And who did what to whom? No one was interested in Gina. Because all knew that she was a fake bitch. Well, she liked me. Maybe she loved me in a way a bitch can love. Right, I was way too much for her, I get it. But I am not herablassend, I'm not diminishing people because they're not that smart. I could be. Remember Ana Barrena gossiping with that, I would say dummy? She once thought she was smart because she owned a store. And the store was chic. I went. And I ordered something, un encargo. I never finished because I couldn't pay it. She looked like a real dummy. And Ana Barrena, who acted like an alien asshole, she was smart in comparison to the dummy. Yeah, and La Chava de la Unam, the other person, she was always very eager to say Chava, Chava, Chava. Because that was that Unam thing. But she looked like Julia, but twice the size as tall. But she was diminishing everyone because she said she was a better person being La Chava. So she despised me because of the color of my skin. And she put me in some kind of drawer. But she never asked me a question, she never looked. In comparison, she was privileged and I wasn't. But because of the skin, she considered that I was the privileged one and she was the undermined. Yeah, that is not Klassenbewusstsein, people. Conscience of class, that's not what that is. You gotta look again. I know, I brought all the rules to an end and I brought a paradigm to be observed. Yeah, I was probably the most broke person in the country and I looked also the most elegant one. Yeah, and think about my positive outlook. I never look at people diminished. I can tell you that whatever that was, yeah, Raoul's friends, they were a bunch of dummies. But maybe they thought they were successful in their jobs. but I just observe. I don't really judge, so I don't think I looked at them like they were dummies. I just sit there and observe, just like, I don't know, like an open book. And when I go home, I think about, man, that must be hard for Roland and Stella to be among such dummies because they're not stimulated intellectually. Just because of the habit, because once they shared the same bench at school. Yeah, it's lonely to be that bright when you don't have your partner. But Raoul had Estella, and Estella had Raoul. But I was the one who had none. The only thing I could hang on in all these years was, it's good to know I can call someone when I need it. It's good to know I can call. Yeah, do you think I could call Elik? He had threatened me. I could not call him. I couldn't even put my heart on him. Shit, Elik. Fuck you, man. Oh, Antonio? No. Oh, Carlos Sissy? No. Oh, Doña Filia, who robbed me blind at the end, but she didn't. She paid back, but it took a lawyer. No. Oh, who am I else? No, I could call Lalo, which I, of course, I never did. Only when I needed something for the car. But just the fact I could trust someone. And then I could go and see Estella. I could go see them both, but Raoul then left. And it wasn't that she cooked when I was announced. It was the field we shared just there. In silence. Yeah, I tanked myself a little bit because I was exhausted with all the work I did. And back. Yeah, almost never. I did not achieve that with anybody else. No, Miriam, absolutely not. Because Miriam was needy. Because she felt undermined because of her looks, I guess. When someone is that needy, he or she cannot really give anything. She had not quite accepted her reality, and Estella did. Yeah, it's kind of weird to say. Maybe I had more in common with Assas. I gave him a lesson for a year, once a week in a coffee place. And we talked, yeah, did we talk the entire year about the same book? Yeah, why not, right? Yeah, because I'm smart and they're not that bright. They need a little bit more time. It was his idea this time. It wasn't mine. It was the book where Freud and Fromm were analyzed. No, Fromm analyzed Freud and Marx. Erich Fromm analyzed Karl Marx and Sigmund Freud. Great book. And he liked cats. He really liked cats so very much. No, he told me about... He didn't say, I like cats. He talked to me about what he liked about them and how much he enjoyed it, so I noticed he liked cats. Because he observed, he was so ugly that he could actually observe people. I'm pretty sure he was actuario. I don't know what that is. It's an insurance accountant. Yeah, I still don't know what it is. He gave me a book he wrote. Yeah, I didn't read it. And because it's not my subject, I don't want it. Yet I'm pretty sure he read Sartre and Kafka. I think he did. Because he was so interested in actually discussing them in a way. And probably also, I don't know. Well, he had me there for a year and then we did the foundation. So then he did not have me anymore. Because then I lived in Cuernavaca and when the foundation had events, well then he came and I hosted. But that was not having me, that was just being among other people. After we never met alone anymore, ever, as I started working on the foundation. I never saw him in the city. He only came to the foundation when I said, there's an event, it's that day, and this is what's going to happen. So then he came. That's all.
I guess you wonder where I've been. I searched to find a love within. I can't let go. My friends wonder what is wrong with me. Well, I'm in a daze from your love, you see. I came back to let you know. Got a thing for you, and I can't.